Too Late to Run. Chapter 1 to Chapter 5. It all began with a grand wedding ceremony that took place at a well-known exhibition center in Fairford City. The guests invited to this wedding were all upper-class celebrities and scions of distinguished families. At this moment, the wedding ceremony was reaching its climax. Dressed in an off-the-shoulder wedding dress, the bride walked in step by step from outside the conference hall to the center stage while holding a bridal bouquet. Champagne roses carpeted the entire aisle. Under normal circumstances, the groom should have been waiting for the bride's arrival long ago. But only the lone bride and the MC, whose facial expression was exaggerated, were the only ones on stage. However, the guests offstage felt nothing abnormal about this situation. At this moment, the MC on the stage delivered the congratulatory wedding speech with great joy and enthusiasm. Congratulations to Miss Yvonne Page and Mr. Henry Kingston, who V-tied the knot on this warm and blossoming spring day. The two of them are really a handsome couple and a match made in heaven. But before the MC could finish delivering his speech, a gust of wind blew past them and lifted Yvonne's bridal veil, revealing a hideous and horribly swollen face that could not even be covered up with superb makeup skills. The guests present couldn't help but gasp when their eyes fell upon Yvonne's face. One of the guests even cried out uncontrollably, "Isn't this too disgusting?" As soon as that person blurted out those words, the other guests began whispering among themselves sarcastically as well. "Young Master Henry is now a badly disfigured living corpse. TSK. TSK. What's wrong with finding such a mate for him? The fact that the Page family sent a daughter to suffer beside a living corpse in order to curry favor with the Kingston family is quite bold of them too." "Ha. You're right. Who else other than a living dead would dare take such a woman as a wife? Otherwise, could she even be married off?" "You have a point. I heard that she was recently brought back from the countryside and is ill-educated." The comments offstage slowly turned offensive, and Yvonne could vaguely hear some of them even though she was a bit far away from the guests. Quickly, she put out her hand to press her veil down. The MC then rattled on and on about the bride and groom being well suited for each other, to which the guests offstage responded by laughing and talking with greater derision. After the MC had finally finished delivering his perfunctory speech, Yvonne lifted the skirt of her wedding dress and descended the stage alone, preparing to seat herself at the banquet table to have something to eat. However, she had barely walked a few steps when a woman stopped her directly and said, "The old master wants you to go back to the Kingston residence and keep young Master Henry company. That way, it can foster the spousal relationship between you two." Yvonne was stunned. How was she supposed to foster a relationship with a badly disfigured vegetable? Was this going to be a horror story? Seeing that Yvonne was silent, the woman gave her a sneer. "The chauffeur is waiting for you at the door," she said before ordering the few bodyguards next to her. "Send young Mistress Kingston back to the Kingston residence." Yvonne let out a sigh. "It seems like I can't even have a bite at my own wedding banquet today," she thought to herself. Meekly, she replied, "I understand." Her voice was surprisingly soft, sweet, and melodious, just like a piece of flowing music. It sounded so soothing to the ears that the woman was dazed for a moment. By the time she came back to her senses, Yvonne had already followed the few bodyguards out of the wedding venue unaccompanied. Staring at Yvonne from behind, the woman said with a disdainful look, "As expected, she is an ugly thing who is unpresentable to the public. Nonetheless, she is a perfect match for the current young Master Henry. Ever since becoming a vegetable after the accident, young Master Henry was now a disgraced and abandoned worthless piece of trash in the Kingston family. The fact that he was fixed up with a random, ugly woman was enough proof of the Kingston family's attitude toward the young master. The two of them were a perfect couple indeed." Yvonne came in front of a luxurious car under the escort of the bodyguards. Even though young Master Henry was now a disgraced good-for-nothing, the Kingston family couldn't lose its pomp and grandeur. Yvonne was about to get into the vehicle when she suddenly heard someone calling her name from behind. "Yvonne, wait a minute." She looked back to see a middle-aged man running speedily toward her. He was Benjamin Page, her father, whom she had just reconnected with. Benjamin walked up close to Yvonne before saying anxiously, "You just came back from an off-the-grid village with no knowledge of the etiquette here. So you should speak less when you get to the Kingston residence." Yvonne trembled nervously as she asked in a soft, sweet voice full of fear and dread, "I am scared, Dad. Can I not get married?" Benjamin sighed heavily as he replied, "It is all my fault, Yvonne. It is my fault for being unable to protect you. I have no choice but to let you suffer in the Kingston family." He promised firmly and solemnly immediately afterward, "Don't worry, once the company pulls through the crisis, I'll definitely find a way to save you from the Kingston family." Excited, Yvonne pulled off her veil and asked, "Really?" Benjamin's breath hitched for a moment when he saw Yvonne's face right in front of him. After recovering himself, he immediately said, "I am your father, how can I possibly lie to you? Also, you don't have to be afraid. Young Master Henry is now a vegetable, what else can he do to you?" Anxiously crumpling the skirt of her wedding dress with her hands, Yvonne said in a voice choked with tears, "I heard people talking about how young Master Henry was badly disfigured after the accident. He looks grotesque and grossly terrifying now." Benjamin's eyes flickered with guilt, so he immediately diverted the topic by saying, "Who doesn't he want to marry into the Kingstons? The most powerful family in Fairford City. They only said that out of jealousy toward you." As he spoke, his gaze fell upon Yvonne's hideous face. He promptly urged, "Hurry up and put on your veil." Yvonne put her veil back on pitifully. Then, Benjamin helped her into the car as he said, "Go back to the Kingston residence first and wait until I come to get you later." With that, he told the chauffeur to drive off. The car slowly started up and left the exhibition center, gently wiping the tears off her cheeks. Yvonne muttered in a soft and faint voice, "Will you really come to save me?" The chauffeur drove all the way into the Kingston residence and made several turns before stopping in front of a Western-style building. Yvonne got out of the car to see a group of people waiting for her outside the mansion. They were led by a woman, who was old Madame Kingston's trusted aide. The woman led Yvonne all the way to the easternmost room on the third floor of the Western-style building. She stepped into the room, but before she had enough time to survey their surroundings, she discovered that the door had been closed from the outside. A man's displeased voice could vaguely be heard outside the door as he said, "What are you doing?" What followed was the woman's cold reply, "Tonight is young Master Henry's wedding night. So the old madam told me to keep watch. She also wanted me to remind you that this bride is the life-extending mascot found specially for the young master. And she will be living in young master's room." Yvonne's heart went pit-a-pat as she listened to these words. Was she going to be locked up to death together with a vegetable? As she tried her best to ignore the noise outside, her eyes fell upon the large bed by the window. A man was lying on the bed. "This must be that living dead husband of mine," she thought to herself. Yvonne couldn't see the man clearly since she was standing near the door. After a moment's pause, she took off her veil as she walked toward the bed. She was merely three steps away from the bed when she caught a clear glimpse of the man's face. Yvonne had prepared herself for what she was about to see, but she still froze on the spot at this very moment. Wasn't he young Master Henry of the Kingston family, badly disfigured after meeting an accident? Didn't they say he looked like a demon who had crawled out of hell? Who was this breathtakingly handsome man in front of her? Dumbfounded, Yvonne stood there in a daze for a long time. Was the man on the bed an illusion? Would he vanish like bubbles with a light touch? She took another few steps forward. After getting close to the bed, she leaned over and carefully poked the man's face with her finger. He was real. Yvonne looked at him in confusion as she muttered, Wasn't he supposed to look hideous and grotesque after being disfigured in an accident? Henry was the eldest grandson of the Kingston family. He had been considered a powerful figure in the commercial world ever since taking over the Kingston Group 5 years ago. But that came to a halt when a devastating accident turned him into a vegetable 6 months ago. His condition was currently deteriorating, and it was rumored that he had little time left to live. This was precisely why his family had hurriedly found a wife for him. As it turned out, Yvonne was the bride chosen to be his life-extending mascot. Yvonne managed to connect the dots roughly as she stared at her newly wedded husband. Henry might have been very formidable in the past, but he was now a loser in a power struggle within the Kingston family. Naturally, the outside world would belittle a loser as much as they could, which led to the situation where the rumors didn't correspond with reality. People only let themselves be victimized when their fates are out of their control, concluded Yvonne with a soft and sweet sigh. Then, she glanced at the man on the bed and introduced herself by saying, "I am Yvonne Page, and I'll fulfill my duty as your wife before you die." Having greeted the man on the bed, she massaged her sore body. After being put through a hassle since that morning until now, all she wanted was to take off her wedding dress and get a good night's sleep as quickly as possible. Yvonne stood up and walked toward the bathroom. When the sound of water came out from the bathroom, the persistently closed eyes of the man lying on the bed flickered visibly for an instant. "Huh? Before I die, a dutiful wife." Wrapping herself in a bath towel, Yvonne came out of the bathroom and walked toward the wardrobe on one side of the room. However, inside the wardrobe were all men's clothes. Not only that, they were dark-colored and depressing to look at as well. Yvonne took out a piece of dark-colored lycra wear and put it on. She wasn't short in stature, but the lycra wear was oversized on her, making her look like a kid who secretly wore an adult's clothes. After getting dressed, Yvonne's eyes fell upon the exquisitely made desserts served on the table in the room. She walked straight up to the table, sat down on the sofa, and started feasting unceremoniously. It was only after she finished off the desserts on her plate did Yvonne finally feel that her empty stomach had stopped disagreeing with her. Having eaten her fill, she lounged lazily on the sofa. However, the sofa was made of solid wood and was not comfortable at all. It even hurt her a little while she sat on it. After a day of exhaustion, Yvonne just wanted to lie on a soft and comfortable bed. Following her heart's desire, she turned her gaze to the large bed nearby. After hesitating for a long time, she stood up and walked toward the bed. "I guess he won't blame me anyway," she thought to herself. She negotiated with the man in a soft and sweet voice. "I'll be sleeping on the bed. Tell me if you have any objections." Naturally, Henry did not respond since he was in a vegetative state. "Since you aren't saying anything, I'll just take that as a yes." Yvonne crawled into bed and lay down like a kitten. After rolling onto her side to look at Henry, she couldn't help but reach out her hand and poked his peerlessly handsome face. She then said, "Tonight is our wedding night, so I consider us to be sleeping together." After murmuring a few words in a desultory way, she slowly closed her eyes and soon fell asleep. Yvonne was sleeping peacefully at first, but she had a nightmare in the later half of the night. In her dream, a ravening wolf was staring at her with a dark, fierce gaze, as it pressed down on Yvonne and strangled her. It even spoke in human language. It said, "I have an objection." Yvonne was in deep sleep when she heard a continuous knock at the door the next morning. Annoyed, she tried to cut herself off from the noises by burying her head into the arms of the soft body pillow next to her. The knock at the door stopped after a little while, but the noise in the room grew louder. Yvonne sat up with her head drooping, getting up on the wrong side of the bed. She mumbled angrily, "I am on leave. I am not taking on any more projects." Then, she slowly opened her eyes with great difficulty and was surprised to see a bunch of strangers before her. They were looking at her like she was a pervert, Mr. Statham. The Kingston family S. butler who was leading them looked like he wished he could kill her with a look in his eyes. Yvonne was speechless. Did she do something outrageous? While in a state of stupefaction, she vaguely sensed that something was wrong with what her hand was touching. She lowered her head to take a look at her hand and was stunned to see it resting on a man's chest. Not only that, the man's upper body was naked as well. Flustered, she instantly kept a distance from the half-naked man as if she had just touched something burning hot. Why is this guy underneath my hand? Mr. Statham gave the hideous Yvonne a long stare, suppressing the indignation within him. He kept a straight face and stated the facts curtly. Miss Page, young Master Henry can't move his limbs. Please don't strip off the young master's clothes in the future, or it'll be bad if he catches a cold. Yvonne looked appalled upon listening to his words. Henry was a vegetable, why were his pajamas stripped off for no reason? It seemed like nobody else in the room but Yvonne would be able to pull off such a perverse thing. Did she momentarily lose control of her inner lust and made sexual advances on a vegetable after sleeping in the bed last night? In an instant, Yvonne understood why these people were looking at her like she was a pervert. It was indeed despicable of her to lay her hands on a person in a vegetative state. Feeling terribly ashamed, she jumped out of bed and ran to the bathroom with her face buried in her hands. After she had gone out of the room, a servant behind Mr. Statham said with a look of disgust, "In any case, the young master is the eldest grandson of the Kingston family. Wouldn't he making him marry such a person be an insult to him? Those people have gone too far." Mr. Statham's heart was filled with indignation as well. Who dared to insult young Master Henry like this before the accident? Suppressing his emotions, he shot a glance at the speaking servant with a stern look on his face. "Shut up!" he bellowed. The servant reluctantly hung her head and shut her mouth. Yvonne entered the bathroom and was too ashamed to show her face. When did she become so horny to the point of taking off a man's pajamas? Depressed, she patted her already swollen face and brainwashed herself in an act of self-comfort. She said, "My face is swollen anyway, so it doesn't matter if I lose face or not. I'll just assume that nothing has happened. I'll be a well-behaved and decent lady again after going out of the bathroom." As she comforted herself, her eyes fell upon her knotted shirt and pants. A look of bemusement spread across her face as she said, "I didn't knot my clothes last night, did I? Why would her shirt and pants be knotted tightly right now?" However, she was the only person in the room who could move. Who else could have knotted her clothes? It couldn't have been the vegetable who did it. Yvonne rubbed her aching neck as she muttered, "I must have been too exhausted last night. I can't remember anything I did at all. Getting married was so exhausting." She felt so tired as if her body had been crushed by the weight of someone else. Also, her neck was so painful as if she had been seized by the throat. Having regained her composure, Yvonne walked out of the bathroom. At this moment, several professional caregivers were cleaning and massaging Henry's body. Just then, a servant wheeled a dining cart into the room. Placed on the dining cart was some type of semi-liquid food prepared specially for a vegetative person. Served in a delicate porcelain bowl, it slowly gave off wafts of steam through the half-opened lid. Smelling the aroma of the semi-liquid food, Yvonne became dazed all of a sudden. Her gaze lingered on the food for a moment before she walked toward the dining cart with a greedy look on her face and said, "This smells so good. I want to eat it too." Clutching the cart's handle in her hands, the servant who had wheeled the dining cart inside responded, "Young mistress, this food has been specially prepared for the young master according to his condition. Your breakfast will be prepared separately." Yvonne asked pitifully, "Can't I eat this instead?" "But this is for the young master." As a maid refused Yvonne's request, she looked at Mr. Statham with a helpless look on her face. Seeing what was happening, Mr. Statham said with a straight face, "Miss Page, If you want to have some, I'll have the kitchen prepare it again. The hidden meaning behind his words was clear. This food was meant for young Master Henry, so she shouldn't think about eating it. Yvonne was a little disappointed. However, just as she turned around and was about to walk away from the dining cart, she suddenly lost her balance and fell heavily toward the dining cart. The dining cart was knocked over right away due to Yvonne's weight. As a result, the bowl dropped onto the floor with a clatter and was smashed into pieces, spilling its contents all over the floor. Since all of this had happened so suddenly, Mr. Statham forcibly suppressed his emotions and ordered the other servants to clean up the awful mess at the scene after a moment of stupefaction. It wasn't until the mess was cleaned up that Mr. Statham's eyes fell upon Yvonne, who had just gotten up from the floor. Mr. Statham's eyes had an obvious look of resentful displeasure in them as he looked at Yvonne. He said, "Please be a little more careful in the future, Miss Page. Don't be careless even while walking." "I'll be careful from now on," said Yvonne as she hung her head quietly. Then, she looked at Mr. Statham hopefully and asked, "Are you guys going to prepare breakfast for him again? In that case, can you guys bring another serving for me?" Mr. Statham replied with a straight face and said, "I'll tell the kitchen to make one more serving for you." Yvonne gave him a seemingly simple-minded smile. She said happily, "That's so kind of you." After Mr. Statham left the room with everyone else, Yvonne walked to the side of the bed. She plaintively waved her hands, which had accidentally landed on the porcelain shards just now in front of the man, and said, "Look, I injured my hand because of you." As her hand started bleeding again because of the movement, she quickly took some tissues from the nightstand to cover her wounds. Then, she said in a soft and sweet voice full of grievance, "I have sacrificed a great deal. Look, my hands are disfigured." Having voiced her complaints, she fixed her eyes again on Henry's gorgeously handsome face. His long eyelashes, straight nose, and thin, soft lips, they were all the creator's greatest masterpiece. How could such a breathtakingly handsome face exist in this world? The longer she looked at him, the more she wanted to keep him at home. A glance at him would be enough to make her feel refreshed whenever she was in a bad mood. Unable to restrain herself, she got close to Henry and reached out her hand to poke his face as she whispered, "What a gorgeous little cutie." Just then, the door to the room pushed open all of a sudden. As Yvonne was startled, her arms inexplicably went weak, causing her to fall on top of Henry. Not only that, her lips even landed precisely on Henry's ones. Yvonne froze in an instant. It wasn't until she heard the sound of someone clearing his throat did she come back to her senses. She immediately got up and turned to look at the door. Then, she saw Mr. Statham staring at her with a clouded expression on his face. Yvonne couldn't be more familiar with the look in his eyes. Just a while ago, he had stared at her like this as if she was a pervert. Yvonne was at a loss for words. "I can explain it." Thanks for listening to the Bravanovel audiobook. Welcome to download the Bravanovel app. Read the novel Too Late to Run online and get the latest updates.